Hello, beautiful people. Here we are again on the mat together, bringing our hands to prayer position at our heart space, setting an intention for the day. I woke up with a bit of a stiff back today, so I'm definitely looking for some fluidity, some flexibility, and some pain relief. Bringing the chest forward, dropping the head back, and then pulling back on the knees as we straighten the arms and take the spine towards the back of the room or wherever you're sitting. Bringing the chest forward, arching the back, and then rolling the shoulders, pulling back on the knees. Abs and chest coming forward, leaning over our legs. And then pulling back one more time. Just to create some movement and some heat in the back. Crossing the left leg over the right. And pulling that knee in towards the chest as we twist the upper body around to the left side. Feeling a stretch through the glute muscle. You should feel it quite deep through the body of that muscle. Bottom leg should be relaxed. And then pressing down through the right hand, coming up onto the right knee. Taking the left arm out on an angle so we get a beautiful stretch through the abdominals. And then changing legs, right leg coming over the left, hugging the right knee in towards the chest and taking our gaze over to the right side. The right fingertips should be spread on the earth behind us. And we're breathing deeply, sending oxygen to any tension areas. Planting down through the left hand, pressing up onto the left knee, taking the right leg long this time, right hand overhead, and then stretching it back on a 45 degree angle. And then coming into seated position as we plant down through the right hand, bringing the left arm up and over. Planting down through the left hand, right arm up and over. Just twisting the upper body a little bit. Facing the chest towards the sky. One more time. Interlacing the fingers behind the back, pulling the shoulders back towards the hands, dropping the head, and then bending forward, bringing the upper body over the legs. And then resting our hands on the earth in front or folding your elbows. Or crossing your arms and gently resting your forehead on top. You might feel this stretch around the hip socket. You might feel a stretch through the back as we push back up and then change the legs. So bringing the right foot in front, interlacing the fingers behind the back. And then gently leaning forward as we bring our arms up overhead. And then bending a little bit more. I felt a bit of a twinge in my knee, so I had to pull back and then it kind of clicked in. And then just resting the head on the forearms. Creating some space between the between the neck and the sacrum. Gently coming back up now, coming over into tabletop position. I'm going to run through some cat-cows, so setting up the body, wrists under shoulders, knees under hips, dropping the stomach towards the floor, and then curling the spine towards the sky as we take our gaze between our legs. Dropping the stomach and chest towards the mat, taking our gaze as high as we can, and then taking the gaze between the legs, curling the spine. Should be feeling a little bit of warmth now, especially through the lower half of the back, and hopefully it's starting to loosen up down the spine. Tucking the toes and coming into downward facing dog now as we press the heels towards the mat, taking the hips high. Fingers are spread wide. Maybe bending the knees, taking the chest towards the thighs. Finding some stillness for a moment. And bringing the left leg between the hands. Dropping the right knee to the mat, untucking the toes. And then gently bringing the body backwards, maintaining a bend in the front leg if you want. Coming back into this low lunge, rocking back, going as far as your leg will allow. One more time, shifting your body weight forward, dropping the hips towards the earth, and then coming back, stretching the belly of the hamstring muscle. Planting down through the right hand as we twist the upper body towards the sky, taking the left arm high, and then grabbing the right foot, getting a deep stretch through the front of the right leg. As we pull that foot towards the bottom, gently releasing now, taking the left arm long and then planting both hands back to frame the front foot. Tucking the toe of the right leg, coming into downward facing dog. Maybe pedaling out the legs. Coming into the other side now. So right foot coming between the hands. Left knee drops to the mat. Hips are pressed towards the floor. Gently coming back to stretch the belly of the hamstring in the back of the knee. Shifting the body weight forward. Coming back, taking the bottom back towards the back heel. Forwards one more time. Back one more time. And then we're going to plant down through the left hand this time, taking the right arm towards the sky. And then right arm going long, and then framing the front foot, tucking the toes of the left foot, downward facing dog. High plank. And then lowering down slowly, untucking the toes. Taking our arms by our side. We're going to lift the legs and the arms and the chest and the head off the floor. And then gently coming back down. Again, lifting, maintaining contact through the abdominals, and then lowering. And then lifting, maintaining breath. You don't want to hold your breath here, so make sure you're breathing. And then lowering. This time we're going to grab each foot, pull the feet towards the bottom to get a stretch through the front of the thighs before then pulling the arms away from the shoulders into bow pose. Breathing. And then gently letting the feet go, tucking the toes, downward facing dog. Dropping to our knees. Going to take the left leg out to the side. So we take our arms high, and then the left arm will come down, the left leg, right arm. We'll come overhead for a side bend, and then planting the right hand down, bringing the left leg parallel to the floor, and then coming into the other side. So right leg out to the side, lifting the arms high, right hand running down the right leg, left arm over the top, then left hand plants down, right leg parallel to the floor, right arm to the sky. Knees together, coming in for a closed-legged child's pose. Just letting everything fall heavy here. Letting any tension just be released in this relaxed state. Breathing deeply. Checking in with any thoughts you're having. Are they positive? Are they negative? Before pushing back up onto your knees. And then we're going to windmill the arms to the mat behind the feet. And do a bit of a back bend here. So pushing the pelvis forward, and then gently lowering the bottom to the heels as we come over onto our bottom, and then gently lowering the back to the mat. Coming into bridge pose, so bringing the heels towards the bottom, lifting the hips and the pelvis towards the sky. Pushing through the arms to get some height, and then gently coming down vertebrae by vertebrae back to the mat. Taking the right leg long, left knee comes up and over the right leg, left arm is out to the side, and we're gently guiding the left knee towards the floor. Bringing that knee in towards the chest now, and then stretching the left leg long. Right knee comes up and over the left, and our right arm goes out to the side. You can leave your head neutral if you prefer to just look straight up, or you can look over to the right side of the body. Hugging the right knee in, and then coming in into our final pose, Savasana. I'm going to let you have some peace and quiet today through this pose. So just concentrate on quietening the mind, releasing all thought. Takes a lot of practice. The more you do it, the better you get. Being able to switch off. I'm going to be here for another 3 minutes, so I'll bring you out when it's time to move. Time to start bringing some movement back into the body. Maybe having a little stretch. And when you're ready, rolling over to one side. Pushing up into seated pose. Keeping the eyes closed down. Taking a big deep breath in and then bringing our hands to our third eye. May we have kind and loving thoughts today as we lower them to our lips. May we speak kind and loving words today as we lower our hands to our heart. May we have kind and loving intentions today. Once again, it's been a pleasure to bring this video to you. Namaste.